5 ways to increase your wealth in 2018. I'm going to tell you guys right now, if you find a way to do all 5 of these things this year, watch your wealth absolutely take off. The amount of money you are worth is going to explode. These 5 things are so fundamentally important to increasing your wealth this year. And some of these I've actually never shared in the history of the channel, believe it or not, which is hard because I have over 700 videos on this channel. So to share something I haven't already shared in the past when it comes to personal finance, it's a hard thing to do. Stock market is pretty easy. There's always new stocks coming out and things like that. And the stock market is so deep. But personal finance, increasing your wealth, it's a hard thing to find. So a couple of these will literally change your life as long as you actually adapt them. The first one, this might be the most important of all of them, honestly. It's replacing 1 hour of wasted time per day with 1 productive hour per day. My story, 0 to 200,000 by age 25, should have been 200,000, should have been $1 million. It should have been $1 million, but oh my gosh, did I like to waste time on little time-sucking things, okay? I used to play Call of Duty for several hours almost every single night. I used to play that mobile game called Clash of Clans for several hours per day. I used to watch reruns of Family Guy and The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air all night long. I used to do that. During the fall time, every Saturday and Sunday, I'd watch football from the time I woke up to the time I went to bed. Oh my gosh, the amount of time I wasted on little time suck activities when I could have been using those hours for productive tasks, it's mind-blowing to me. And every single person I've ever come across in this world wastes a lot of time, guys, on these little time suck activities that are just, you know, you zone out for several hours or whatever. I've still yet to meet a person in real life that has literally no time in their day where they can't do anything. They're just like so busy and whatnot. Almost every single person out there, every single person watching this video, you've got at least 1 hour. You've probably got a lot of hours, but if you take just 1 hour a day that's wasted on unproductive time and you put that toward productivity, which is learning about something or you know, something that's gonna make money. Obviously, you're trying to increase your wealth this year, right? You learn about something making money, either passive income, investing related, whatever it is, okay, whatever your thing is. You spend that time learning about that and then you actually start adapting those ways and you start actually using those strategies. I'm gonna tell you, it's gonna make a massive difference in your life. Just 1 hour a day, guys. I used to waste so much time, 4, 5, 6 hours a day, and so many people out there are in my same shoes. They'll get home from work or whatever, and they'll watch Netflix for 4, 5, 6, 7 hours straight, guys, and it's like that day in and day out. You take just one of those hours, just one per day on those unproductive tasks, and you turn it toward productivity, my goodness, watch your life explode financially. Number 2 has to do with your workplace, okay? Most of you guys watching this probably work for a company, all right? So something I did when I was in the workforce and something that helped me make more money than pretty much all my peers were making when I was working in the workforce was every single month, at least once a month, I had a one-on-one with my boss about getting promoted. What is it gonna take for me to get promoted? This is very, very key if you wanna increase your wealth and you wanna take it up to the next ranks. You're gonna get one of 3 answers back to you. When you go to your boss and you ask for a one-on-one, if your workplace doesn't do that, you say, I just wanna talk to you for a minute, you know, after work or whatnot, can we chat for a bit? You're gonna get one of 3 responses when you tell them, hey, what is it gonna take for me to get promoted? What, you know, how can I get to the next level and whatnot? You know, one of 3 responses. The first one is, you're not getting promoted, give me a break. He's gonna laugh at you out of town. You're a joke, you're not gonna get promoted. That could happen, that's gonna be one possible response. The next possible response is, sorry, we don't have any openings. We don't have any openings here. You're probably not gonna get promoted because we don't have any openings up the ranks. Or you're gonna get a third response and they're gonna say, well, if you do this and that and this and that, I can, you know, recommend you for promotion and whatnot. You're gonna get one of those 3 responses almost every single time, okay? If it's the first two, then you know you need to go apply for another job somewhere else or start a business or something. Like, you know that's not the place for you. If you get laughed out of town, get a promotion, give me a break. Or you're in the position where, you know, they tell you, you know, there's no promotional opportunities. what are you doing in that workplace? Unless you really just love your job that much, if you just love your job that much, then maybe do it or whatever. But I'm going to tell you, there's a great opportunity for you to increase your wealth by going somewhere else and looking for a better job that pays more and whatnot, that has more promotional opportunities. I can tell you, if I was in a workplace environment where the boss laughed at me, and you know, which a lot of your bosses might do, I'm not going to be at that workplace anymore. And I can tell you, if there's no promotional opportunities, I'm going somewhere else. I don't care. I'm not loyal to that workplace. They're not loyal to me. They don't care about me. You're just another number when you work for a company, right? You're just another number when you work for a company. They don't really care about you in the end. So I'm going somewhere else. I'm going to go find a better job that I can make more money, have more chances to go up the ranks and whatnot. This is a phenomenal thing. You've got to be willing. And I know it might be a little nerve-wracking to ask for that one-on-one, you know, with your boss and kind of ask him this question or whatnot. You just got to do it, man. You just got to get the cojones and go do it. Don't stress about it. And I can tell you, once you've done it once, it gets so much easier. And that's why every single month I was able to have one-on-ones with my bosses and ask them, hey, what's it going to take for me to get promoted? Hey, what about that promotion? You know, have I done this and well enough and this and that? Do that, guys. It's very, very key. Number three is something I preach on this channel so much, and I'm going to continue to preach it, and it's probably always going to make these lists, and it's get a second income stream. Get a second income stream of some kind to help increase your wealth. And once again, this does not have to be a massive thing. A lot of people, when they hear me say second income stream, they automatically in their head think second job. They think, oh my gosh, if I'm going to have a second income stream, I got to get a second job. I got to go, I don't know, work at Taco Bell or go work at the food store, bagging groceries now for an extra 20, 30 hours a week. No, absolutely not. Getting a second income stream, it really has to do with passive income. Now, I'm not going to go into all ideas. I got plenty of videos on the channel about passive income ideas. You can check those out after this video is over if you want, if you need specific ideas. But basically, getting a second income stream is key. Even if it's something that brings in $50, $100, $200 a month. I mean, imagine how effective that can be in your life and increasing your wealth. Especially when you think about it from the perspective of, okay, you make an extra $100 a month doing this little side hustle thing you got going on, this little second income stream, and all of a sudden that turns into, you know, a lot more money when you invest that money and that money starts making you money, right? Not only that, sometimes these little pet projects can turn into the golden goose, okay? The YouTube channel, the financial education channel. I love like, you know, bringing things back to me. I didn't start this thing as like, oh, I'm going to make a lot of money from it. It just happened that, you know, I was more and more successful and it happens to make me a lot of money. But it never started out like, oh man, I'm going to kill it on YouTube. I'm going to make so much money from this. I'm going to have, you know, 100,000 plus subscribers. Like, it never started out like that. It was just like, let me do this thing. You know, yeah, that's cool. Maybe I can make some money for it. Maybe I can make $50, $100 a month or whatever. And what ended up happening, it blew up, and then I ended up dropping an entire real estate marketing company I created because this thing became so big. You guys might get in that position, but even if you don't get in that position where you're killing it, $100 a month, $200 a month, like almost no one would say, oh, that's nothing. Get in that second income stream and imagine the confidence you will get from getting a second income stream that you've done something out there and whatnot. It's a very big confidence boost you get from yourself when you can create a second income stream out of nothing and start making money, guys. It's a very big one. Get that second income stream this year. Number four is cut at least $50 in wasted expenses off of your expense report that you do each month, okay? All of us, we can waste different money on different things, and usually it's a lot of silly things, okay? I'll give you two examples just within the past week in my life, okay, of some examples of some expenses I could easily cut out, and I could cut out way more than $50 a month in my expenses, believe me on that. So yesterday, I'm lazy to cook breakfast, right? We got 18 eggs in the fridge, but I'm like, oh, I'll just go to Starbucks. We got coffee. We can make coffee anytime we want. We got all the flavorings and whatnot. But instead, I go to Starbucks. I get my wife and myself a drink. I get us each a sausage egg breakfast thing, right? $19. $19, guys, on two drinks and two little food items, right? And I could have done all that here at home for less than probably $1 or $2, right? That's a huge waste of money. The other day, my friend and I were going and we're driving out to like Red Rock Canyon type area, right? And I was thinking, oh, I could gas up right here. It's pretty cheap, and you know, but I was like, oh, I got to do a U-turn and I don't feel like gassing up. I'll just gas up at this gas station that's way out there in the desert, right? So I end up driving. We drive all the way out to this far part. I gas up at this station. The price is 20 cents more per gallon than it would have been. It literally, if I gassed up right by me, and I don't know, my car, I think, takes 15, 20 gallons of gas, right? A lot of that's like what, $4 or so there? That's just wasted money. There's so many things all of us do each month that if we could just save this little bit of money, that's just literally like really, I couldn't have done a U-turn there and just, you know, went to that gas station and saved my 20 cents a gallon. I went all the way to the far one. Like these type of decisions, almost every single person's making out there that, you know, are kind of silly expenses or that don't really, you know, bring you much or whatever. And you can find little ways to cut here and there, guys. Save $50 a month. It's big, guys. Imagine if you can take that up to $100, $200. And you'll notice that a lot of times you're not even impacted that greatly. Would I really be impacted that greatly by going to the gas station that was right there instead of going the one way out in the desert? No. Would I have been really that impacted by just deciding to cook breakfast instead of going to Starbucks and spending $19 on two drinks and two little sausage McMuffin things? No. I probably would have been quicker if I would have cooked breakfast here, right? I wouldn't have had to stay in that drive-thru for 20 minutes. So those are the things I'm talking about, guys. Cut $50 in expenses and watch your wealth increase. If you just do $50 a month, that's $600 a year. Compound those numbers over the course of, you know, a decade, two decades, three decades or whatnot. It starts to add up to big numbers, guys, especially on these unproductive things. Number five is start having your money make you money. It's one of the biggest keys in life financially in this world is having your money make you money. It's one thing to make money, okay? And you just put it into, you know, a checking account or whatever, or stuff it under your mattress. That's one thing. The where the money gain changes for people is when they start having their money that they've already made make them money, okay? When you start making your money work hard for you, this is going to be huge. And what you want to do with this one is you want to set goals each month for however much new money you want to put into an account. Or, you know, if you're investing in stocks like I do, that you want to have like a goal, like I want to put $250 or I want to put $500 or $1,000 extra toward my portfolio each month or whatever your goal is, okay? If you're doing real estate investing, you got to have goals like I need to save up such and such amount so I can buy my next rental property or whatnot. I need to save this much by this date. Or if you're doing, you know, bonds or whatever, like whatever it is you decide you want to do, whatever investing route you want to go, set goals each month that are realistic, that you know you can hit and that you hit them each month, and then try to exceed those goals a little bit. You know, if your goal was to put, you know, $150 a month toward your stock market account, try to amp that up, try to beat that, try to do $175 or $200 or something. The goal can be 150, but try to beat it. Just try to get it, you know, exceed it a little bit. Gives you a little more confidence. Setting goals toward investing and whatnot, that what that does basically when you're talking about putting more money into accounts and whatnot, or putting more money, you know, toward real estate or whatever, what that does is it fundamentally changes your mindset to realize, oh, I gotta hit this number. If you don't ever have a goal, what are you doing out there? Like anybody that is successful in this world, they have goals, right? If you're a great athlete, like you have goals. Like you're like, I want to hit this time. I want to be doing this by this month or whatever. You have goals. Like every single big company out there, they have goals. They have quotas they want to do. They have specific numbers. You go to Apple, Samsung, whatever big company you want to go to, every single department has a goal or has a budget or whatever. We got to hit this number. We got to do this many sales numbers or whatever. They've all got goals. So you got to have a goal is, oh, I'm gonna put away $200 at least per month toward account A, B, and C or whatever. That is big, guys. Having your money make you money. It's the biggest thing in the money game, in my opinion, other than obviously making that initial money. But having it make you money, guys, it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful thing. So I hope these five tips helped you out tremendously. You do these five things, your wealth is going to increase massively in 2018 and going forward. You do just a couple of these and you'll still have a great chance of increasing your wealth this year and moving forward throughout time, guys. So anyways, hope you got a lot of value out of this. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching and have a great day. Hey.